And for more analysis on the trial, we bring in civil rights attorney Channa Lloyd, who's with the Cochran firm in Florida. Thanks so much for joining us, Channa. The world has heard the voices of those bystanders who pleaded with Derek Chauvin to get off George Floyd, but now we're meeting them through this court testimony, and some are children. This incident, of course, happened in broad daylight. How impactful do you believe that the testimony of those minors was today?
I think the testimony of the minors was emotionally impactful. It also addressed the fact that no matter the age of the individual, their background, people saw something that they felt was significant enough to want to bring attention to it. And I think that that's very impactful for the prosecution. I think it's very helpful for their case, because what they're showing is that despite anyone's background or training, everyone clearly saw something that made them feel uncomfortable.
I want to play a testy exchange now between Chauvin's defense attorney Eric Nelson and bystander Donald Williams, a trained martial arts fighter.
Do you recall saying, "I dare you to touch me like that. I swear I'll slap the f- out of both of you."
Yeah, I did. I meant it.
Right. So again, sir, it's fair to say that you grew angrier and angrier.
No, I grew professional and professional. I stayed in my body. You can't pay me out to be angry.
And what do you make of Eric Nelson's defense strategy here, focusing on the outrage of that gathering crowd? And is it fair to say that that might have backfired?
I would absolutely say it did backfire today. What he was trying to paint was that there were these other threatening elements that made Mr. Chauvin unable to change what he was doing. He had to be concerned about this angry mob, as they keep trying to make this crowd out to be. And here you take the individual who is most trained to, if you will, create some sort of impact or to be harmful. And he himself was contained. He himself was just trying to bring attention to what was happening to George Floyd. So it really diffused is this idea of this angry mob that Derek's attention was focused on, and that Mr. Chauvin was really trying to, like, keep at bay. I think it really poked a hole in that theory.
And you represent alleged victims of police brutality. In these cases, do you typically find that there is more to the story, perhaps, than what we might see in the police body cam or eyewitness videos? And to that point, how much do juries really rely on these videos when there can be a lot that they don't capture?
In these types of cases, body cam can be helpful or it can just leave mystery. Sometimes it is only the deceased and the law enforcement and a body cam that didn't catch every angle, that didn't see everyone that was there. This situation is very unique in that we have cameras from different vantage points and we have people that came from different vantage points to observe it. So I think that this video is going to be a lot, very impactful on our jury, because you can see from not only the bystander video, but the store cam and other vantage points, you can see exactly what's happening.
And lastly, Chauvin's attorney argued that George Floyd had methamphetamine and fentanyl in his body when he died and an underlying heart condition. Is that a basis, would you say, for a strong defense in this case?
I think that is their strongest defense in this particular set of facts, is going to be that there was another cause of death that was not attributed to Mr. Chauvin. So in that, they're going to try to create a case around that. And I think that is going to be one of the things that you see that they rely very heavily on. And I think we'll start to see a swing in how the defense handles this when it comes to those particular witnesses that are talking about the substance abuse and possible drug use.
Appreciate your insight. Channa Lloyd, thank you so much.
Thank you.
Hi, everyone. George Stephanopoulos here. Thanks for checking out the ABC News YouTube channel. If you'd like to get more videos, show highlights, and watch live event coverage, click on the right over here to subscribe to our channel. And don't forget to download the ABC News app for breaking news alerts. Thanks for watching.